Hello.
Adobe Photoshop, it's pretty much king of the hill. It can do everything, all everything you can come up with. It can fix it, can do it, can, well, it's basically the market standard for image manipulation and etc. Problem is this, it costs money. Let's say you go into this one, annual plan, $21 per month or $240 a year. You can get a couple of extra things, cloud storage. I don't want that, so why can't I untick it? Adobe Fresco, don't use it. Adobe Portfolio, fonts, I don't use it. So why do I have to pay for it, right? $240. Can we save some money using three alternatives? Especially when you don't need all the features, can you save money on it? Well, I think so. I came up with three alternatives to Photoshop. Some online, some offline. And here's my first one. This one is called Pixlr. It has layers, it has a lot of features, smarter tools, so, well, faster editing, it promises a lot of things. And it's an online filter. So let's, you have an express version and a more pro version. Already looked around it. It's online, so it's actually in your browser. This is a picture I took in 2019, it's one of my favorites. In the pull down menu, you see resizing, image rotation, all the basic things that you might need, exposure, well, all the familiar stuff. Over here, you have the similar tools to what Adobe has. But again, it is an online tool. So if you go into very large PSD files or very large images coming from a Sony a7 R4, or the DH50 or the Fuji 100S, well, then probably you're going to pay for Adobe anyway. But, you know, it's, I think it's unworkable to work online. So what's the alternative? Alternative is, for example, something like, let's plop it in there, like Sumo Paint. Sumo Paint, a lot of things that might be interesting to you as a designer or a Photoshopper. Especially for Photoshop, you have all the basic features that you might want to have. When you go into the online version, open it up. What's pricing? Let me see. Oh yeah, you have the free version. That's, we're going to look at that one. The pro version, that's a downloadable version that I'm not going to test. And educational for students, only $20 a month, a year. So let's open up the free version, because that's what we are looking at. Again, in the menu, it has, not going to open an image. Am I? Let's open this one. Shot with my D850. Then you see it needs to upload. And I have a bigger internet connection. So image size, it has a lot of familiar options. Less than the other one, than the photo editor, Pixlr. But for basic photo editing, you can still do most of the things. If you're only using it for painting and that kind of stuff, making drawings online, and you need a free photo editor or free editor, this might be an option for you. I wish I could draw like that. I still draw like a three-year-old. So you see a lot of familiar things and options. So that's an alternative. Paint.net is a downloadable version. It has been around for 17 years, I believe. 16, 17 years. It's about perfect, yeah. 10 years ago. Impressive. Yeah, 14 years ago. But still, I don't want to diss the software because it's been around a long time. It's free. You know, you don't need a high-end PC to run this software. That's another interesting thing. So you can do all the basic things that you want to do. If you want to download it, there are two versions. A paid version, that's a one-time fee to the developers. Basically to say thank you, so that's something to consider. The other one is a free version. You get something like this. This is paint.net 4.2.15, so the latest one. When you go through the toolbar or the menu bar, it pulls down all the menus that you can use or might want to use or can think of. Duplicate layers, all the bells and whistles are here. most of the time we'll use for photo editing. And again, it's free, so $240 saved, right? So here you have all the basic menus again. Zoom, well, what was it? Magic wand. So if that's all you use, this might be or could be a good alternative. This one is called Photo Post Pro. Nice images. It has a mistake on the website. It should say 10 million downloads, not 10. I don't know what that number is. It has hundreds of tools and functions, 24-hour customer service. Well, that indicates that there is a free version and a paid version. So you have a free version and a paid version. First of all, let's go to the free version. The pro version probably has extra features, etc., etc. If you download it, you get something that looks like this. This is Photo Post Pro. Again, 2019 bird. It has all the similar features as Photoshop. This is my buddy. He comes around every year to ask for a peanut. Comes up to my back door and makes a noise, and then I know he's there and he gets a peanut. It's a big animal. It's as big as a car. Over here you have all the menus again, which is interesting. Chalk. That's nice. Over here you have the menus. So all the familiar things that you might need. This one I haven't seen before. Negative filters. So that's a good option. Difference between Adobe Photoshop is that you have to get used to the new layouts and new menus, and all of a sudden this looks different than you're used to. But again, it saves you $240 a year. That's a real nice one. That's GIMP. GIMP has been around for a very long time. Interesting that jumps out at you. It supports more than just Windows. Linux, Apple, of course Windows and other operating systems. So that might be an alternative if you have an old computer. Install Linux on it, install GIMP on it, and you got a workstation. And you save $240 in subscription fees. Then again, it's not Adobe Photoshop. High quality photo manipulation, well, it's promising. But what does it look like? I'm going to show you in a minute, because I want to tell you, there is documentation, there's tutorials to learn you how to use it. So that's an interesting thing. Documentation like the manual in different languages, tutorials, that's already said. Okay. Now you can download it by a torrent or by via directly. So what does it look like? Well, it looks like this. This is GIMP. Again, same image, you know. Menu has pretty much everything you might need or can think of. And is a good alternative if you learn the interface. It is, to be honest, I do think this is one of the better alternatives to Photoshop. It does have all the features and tools that you can... it's all there. The menu thing. This is something that's interesting. I wish Adobe would take that on. Yeah, that's really... Yeah, that's... So this is GIMP. Let me know what you think. If you know more alternatives to Adobe Photoshop in the comments. If this video has helped you in any way, shape, or form, let me know that you're appreciated by a like or a dislike, whatever is up to you. I prefer a like and a comment. So there you go. And I'll start to work on the next video. Thank you so far. Thank you. Bye-bye.